Now, today, we will be going back to Gotham Knights and checking it out in 2024. Now, I know a lot of people like this game, and I know a lot of people dislike this game. Me, I'm a little in between. I enjoyed it when it first came out, but then going back and playing it, and then comparing it to Marvel's Avengers, it's kind of like, it's all right. Both games have, you know, repetitive counterparts, correct? But I feel like the only reason that Gotham Knights might outshine Marvel's Avengers is the open world aspect. But me, that's just me, personally. So we're just gonna play it and see how I feel while I'm playing it again in 2024. Let's get it. Now, the first problem I had with this, you know, this intro, prologue, whatever you want to call it, is I'm not a huge fan of Batman, but why the fuck didn't we get to play as Batman and fight Ra's al Ghul? Like, I'm pretty sure a lot of people would have liked that, but for some odd reason, they didn't do it, which was like, that is a huge miss, in my opinion. But, you know, they did what they did. It's been like, what, 2 years now? So that was a big mess up right there.
Your disappointment, Ephania.
Well, despite everything I've said, this fight scene was goated though. Don't get me wrong, it was definitely good.
Yes. To fight this one.
But I just still think they should have let us play as Batman.
Still flourishes in Gotham, lurking in every shadow.
You don't need that mask. I know it's you, Ra's al Ghul.
You allowed this blasphemy, this sacrilege. Did you think you could keep it from me?
And another thing for a fact, this game definitely could have been better, considering that it was, I do believe that the game was made by the same people that made Batman Arkham Origins, which was not made by Rocksteady whatsoever. So they could have brought that combat into this game, and I probably would have liked the game a whole lot more. And plus, Batman Arkham Origins is my personal favorite Batman Arkham game. I know a lot of people dislike it, and I know, of course, a lot of people like it as well, but to me, I just feel like it's way too underrated.
No one's coming to help you.
I'll deal with you myself.
Not defeat me. I am eternal.
Unlike you, I'm not afraid of dying. I'd rather keep my humanity.
Now, I know a lot of people are gonna like want my opinion on like which games do I think are better between Gotham Knights, Marvel's Avengers, and Suicide Squad. And what I can say, considering that I've played all three of them and I've beaten all three of them, it's kind of like, I want to say it depends on which category you want to put it into. When it comes to the story, I would say they're all okay at best, but Suicide Squad probably has it had the worst story. I can say that. I mean, like, it was an interesting story, but they could have found a better way to do it, of course. Gotham Knights story is like, you know, Batman dying and the rest of the Bat family has to, you know, like, step up, protect Gotham, and live on, you know, to see if they can, you know, go up with his legacy. So that's kind of more understandable. Marvel's Avengers is about a certain situation happening on Avengers Day, and then the Avengers fall apart. Kamala Khan comes in and, you know, she reunites the Avengers. They don't want to get reunited at first, and by them, I mean Tony Stark. And, you know, Bruce Banner, kind of, but they all end up reuniting and defeating MODOK. So it's kind of like out of all of those stories,
Gotham,
I would say my top two are probably, you know, Marvel's Avengers and Gotham Knights. Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League is definitely last. Especially how they killed certain characters, like Batman. Again, even though I'm not a huge fan of Batman, but I know the type of things that Batman is capable of. And it's like, the way that they killed him was just, it was just stupid. I see why a lot of people, you know, didn't fuck with it. And now, Flash, I mean, it's all right. His death was okay, I guess. Green Lantern, you know, he got his willpower drained. You know, he was weak. Then got shot in the head by Deadshot, of course. The Flash got shot, and then he got pissed on. So technically, they all die by bullets. Bullets to the head, basically. The only person that doesn't die by a bullet to the head is literally Superman. Now, if they would have did that, that would have pissed a lot of people off, because we all know Superman is bulletproof. So if they would have did that,
I'm dead.
It would have made absolutely no sense whatsoever, like at all.
When I destroyed the cave and everything it contained.
Now, combat wise, between all three of these games, I'm definitely going to give it to Marvel's Avengers, because Gotham Knights compared to Marvel's Avengers, the combat is ass compared to Avengers, and the skill tree is a lot smaller and a lot more ass compared to the Avengers. Now, Suicide Squad, I mean, I would say I prefer Gotham Knights combat over Suicide Squad, but Suicide Squad isn't really like, it's not really about combat. It's legit, literally a third person shooter. So it's mainly, you know, all about shooting, not combat, not hand to hand fighting, you know, stuff like that. But in my personal opinion, Marvel's Avengers takes the cake and all that. But again, that's just me.
Gotham's criminals to realize that Batman is gone. And you can't count on the GCPD. They haven't trusted us since Jim died.
You are clear to engage.
Grenade! is the base of operations. Some of the technology is outdated, but it has the gear you need and all of my files.
Many of you knew Bruce from Gotham's celebrity pages. A handsome, charming billionaire. And he was that. But he was more than a headline. He was my nephew. He was a friend, a mentor, and a benefactor to those of us gathered here today. And to those of you who didn't know him as we did, I want to tell you this. Bruce was Gotham. He loved this city more than he loved anything. He was a protector to this city. He worked tirelessly behind the scenes to bring justice and equality. There's nothing he wouldn't do. No project he wouldn't champion if he thought Gotham would benefit. And I think in remembering that, we remember Bruce as he truly was.
Always had my back when I needed you. I know you'll keep Gotham safe. Good luck. And goodbye.
How's Alfred?
What you'd expect. Took him 3 years to agree to a vacation and Bruce turned up dead. He asked for some time.
He knows none of us were there either, right?
What about you? You let Jacob Kane give the eulogy.
He offered. He thought it'd be easier on us if he was the one to do it.
Now, if you guys know me, or at least you probably don't, but you probably should.
All that talk about
either way,
protector.
Y'all know that my favorite Batman member family is Jason Todd, a.k.a. the Red Hood. So, of course, that's who I'm going to pick.
Catherine wouldn't be there if she suspected.
I'm skipping this.
I can't see the anti-vigilante police commissioner presiding at Batman's funeral.
Gotham, you. So this professor was Batman's last case?
Kirk Langstrom. The half-finished file was attached to Batman's code black. There's something big there.
Hopefully that means a fight. Could stand to let out some aggression right now.
Now, I can't say another thing that actually bothered me about this game was no performance mode. Like, why wouldn't they add a performance mode? That's something that all games should actually have nowadays, but I guess that's just something we had to deal with while playing this. But I did hear that the PC version had performance mode,
Kirk Langstrom,
and it was like Why give PC right. performance I'll mode, but not, you know, consoles? So, we, you know, we just have to deal with it. So, it's like, whatever. I mean, while the graphics are decent, though.
Shit. So, our scientist got himself dead. Where's his office?
I remember reading that Langstrom's office is in Moulton Hall on the third floor.
Thanks. Huh. Someone left the doors open on the third floor. This is it. Not seeing much police work here. Guess Langstrom kicked it somewhere else.
It's been a long time since I played the story. I'm trying to remember, do I exactly remember what to do? Oh yeah, it was this, the scratches.
Okay, those marks are weird.
Not much on my end yet. You need anything, big guy?
I got this.
You don't need to do all of this alone if something's weird.
Sounds like you don't trust me.
I mean,
Nightwing.
When the game came out, I actually did do a walkthrough on the channel, but it was a non-commentary walkthrough. And if you guys want like a, you know, a walkthrough with commentary, I'm down to do so. That's only if you guys want it. So in the comment section below, just, you know, just let me know.
Langstrom was busy working when he was attacked. He lost a lot of blood fast. Tried to run, but the attacker pinned him to the wall. He didn't have a chance. Just before he died, Langstrom tried to get to that cabinet. What could be so important? Well, well, well. A hidden door. You're full of surprises, Dr. Langstrom.
I'm skipping this because I ain't got time for
it. Got it. Time to find out what you were hiding, Langstrom.
I mean, I got the time. I just didn't feel like doing it. Looking for a code.
The hell's going on in here? This can't be normal university research. Langstrom's desk. Let's see what he's been up to down here. What is this? A hard drive. Must be important if it was hidden down here. Better get this back to everyone. I'm done here. I don't think the cops saw the marks on the walls, and they definitely didn't see the hidden lab. I'm bringing you a hard drive I found in there.
Can't wait to decrypt that bad boy. See you soon.
Seriously, no one could have seen me.
These guys look so damn stupid. And now, in my opinion, this is where we get to the most disappointing part of the game for me, which is literally the combat.
Oh crap, it's Red Hood. What's he doing here?
So like the combat system is like you pretty much just tap the same button over and over again. It's like there are like no special combos or anything.
And now the freaks are here setting fire.
It's literally just, you know, X to melee attack and Y for ranged attacks. I mean, the stealth part of it is decent though, actually. I'm because, you know, stealth, it's... up. It doesn't require much. You just sneak up behind him and you just do an attack. Even though what I just did wasn't really, you know, that. But the stealth parts, they're cool or whatever. But it's really the more engaging, you know, the more engaging fights that disappoint me. Because, of course, when I heard that it was being made by the same people that made Arkham Origins, you would think, oh, it's going to have Arkham-style combat. Definitely not the case.
Hey, look up here! I'm a professor of...
Hey, shut the fuck up.
Just gotta stay out of sight.
Are the fumes getting to you, buddy?
Don't fight it. This never gets old.
Smashy, smashy, smash, smash!
Alright, now we got that out of the way. Well, those freaks out of the way. No pun intended. You said, what?
Damn it, this whole place is gonna burn down.
Now that I think about it, the boss fight, I don't really remember having that many boss fights in this game. I think the only one I can really remember is Mr. Freeze. And that was actually, it was actually a pretty cool boss fight. All honesty, I actually did enjoy it. Get these people behind the desk.
You were unbelievable.
Freeze. Don't move.
Yeah, the only two boss fights I can really remember are Mr. Freeze. You know, Bruce when he came back from the Lazarus Pit. I think we fought Talia al Ghul too. And Ra's al Ghul too, if I can't remember. Like I said, it's been a long time since, you know, since I actually played the story of the game. But I do remember fighting Bruce when he got resurrected from the Lazarus Pit.
Okay, I'm done playing.
Ow. Red Hood was definitely my favorite character in this game, though. Easily.
Firefighters and paramedics are on the way. Are you hurt?
I'm fine. I'm bringing in the hard drive I found so we can crack it open together. Maybe we'll find out what got Langstrom killed.